thank you so much. An excellent setup for our next guest, retired Army Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Davis. He's a senior fellow for Defense Priorities. Good to see you.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, what do you make of Kim Jong-un trying to negotiate with China ahead of the expected meeting in May between Kim Jong-un and President Trump?
Yeah, I think that he's doing everything that he can to try to improve his position, because I think that he knows how weak it really is. And I think it underscores that the United States and President Trump have all the cards. Time is on our side, and we don't have to have any kind of crazy negotiations or give away anything to keep America safe, because our deterrence is going to continue to do that. Kim recognizes that. He's doing everything he can to try to improve his situation, but I'm not sure that it's going to work very well against President Trump.
But we can underestimate how tough this negotiation is really going to be for all sides, including the president. You know, I've been reading into this. Robert Zoellick, he's the former World Bank president. He outlined in the Wall Street Journal these 10 points of negotiation that the White House must consider, because this stuff is not easy to negotiate. You have to figure out what you want and how you're going to get it, and you're not going to cave.
Well, there's no doubt that it's going to be very difficult. But I think, though, the bottom line, I think it's going to be a lot more difficult for Kim Jong-un than it's going to be for Donald Trump, because we can go on for a long time. The pressure and the time pressure is on Kim because of all these sanctions and the pressure they're having. We don't have that pressure. We have all the time in the world, and we can continue to deter literally forever.
What do we really want from North Korea? Because we can say, okay, pause or stop making your nuclear weapons, but that doesn't necessarily ensure that they shut down the factories, etc.
No, it doesn't. And here's the bottom line, that, you know, some people are talking about using a military strike or you know, bloody nose, or even a large military strike. But I can tell you that is the worst possible way to solve this problem. Huh. It would be great if we could just say, hey, you know, we want to work toward denuclearization. We want that to happen. But if we make that our objective and then the negotiations don't work, then that almost says, OK, well, then we have to go to war. But we don't have to go to war to keep America safe and to keep to prevent any war from going on in the peninsula, because we have our deterrent that's both conventional and nuclear, and we have the upper hand on this.
What would you advise President Trump right now?
I would advise President Trump to absolutely talk, to let's discuss, and let's say, you know, the UN Security Council resolutions require a denuclearization, so we're on the same sheet of music on that. But we understand that that it's not very likely that they're going to just give that up, because then they become vulnerable. And that means then that we will continue to keep the sanctions on in place,
right.
We'll continue the pressure, and we'll continue to keep the country safe.
Final question. We need South Korea. We need Japan, and we need China's support in all this, correct? Do you think this trade war brewing and some concessions and exemptions that have been made work in our favor for their support?
You know, that's an open question, and I'm sure the president is understanding how all those things balance out.
Right.
But I think that it's President Trump is just trying to maximize the benefit for our country.
All right. Lieutenant Colonel Davis, thank you so much. Great perspective this morning. We appreciate
it. Thank you.